I would like to express my the president of the APT and then Mr.
Set aside the word digital divide and start working on a new word called digital bridge. How do we do it? We do it by very simple, to lay fiber optics throughout the country. This year alone, the Ministry of Digital has, for the past 5 months, laid fiber optics to 20,000 villages in 5 months. And by next year, we have promised, that should be a big clap for next year, we have promised the government that we will get every village in Thailand to have access to broadband, to high-speed internet, 75,000 villages. Now we hope this will be a good example for many of our friends that this is doable and this is not as expensive as it used to be. And we adhere to the principle of the three A's, which I think ITU has told us for many decades now, and that is for telecommunication networks and internet services, availability, accessibility, and now we are working on the affordability so that people at the village level can have opportunity as equal as people in Bangkok. And we are working very diligently to make it happen. Secondly, we also realize that as a developing countries, we are handicapped by the fact that we have to import a lot of technologies, especially digital technologies. So for the first time, we are now allocating a big piece of land at the center of the so-called Eastern Economic Corridor to establish the so-called first ever Digital Park Thailand. It's going to be a development center for things like Internet of Things, sensor technology, artificial intelligence, some robotics, and of course, a lot of big data and a lot of data center. Number three, I just want to inform you that in doing so, we also need to get engagement of all provinces in the country. In Thailand, we have 77 provinces. And this is sort of very exciting also because next year we are going to make sure that six experimental smart cities will happen for six provinces in Thailand. You know Phuket Island, you know Chiang Mai, you know Khon Kaen, and the EEC, which cover three provinces. We will set as examples for these six provinces, which can be smart differently, so that the rest of the country, another 71 provinces, will request the government and request the society that they want their own province to be smart also, according to their local needs and local context. So within, I would say, 5 years, we will have 77 smart cities in Thailand. Now, this is exciting because is the time that if we are successful very shortly in laying down foundation and the infrastructure for the society and for the country, we will be able to do what we preach, and that is provide opportunities to the population. And this is exciting because we now have many new items to work on. I just talked to Mr. Secretary General of ITU, the fact that we are now in the age of new economic platform led by startups. And we have witnessed for the past 2 years in Thailand that this is the potential economic platform of the country. And if we can lay down a good platform and ecosystem for them, they will grow. And if they grow, the country will grow. And if the country grow with a good connectivity and interaction among many countries in the region, then the region can grow. So the name of the game is we grow together, which is the spirit of ITU, which is the spirit of APT. So ladies and gentlemen, these are just some of the excitement that Thailand is going through. And it's not, it did not take long. Let me assure you, in digital age, we do digital things. We do economy of speed. And this is viable and this is feasible. So Thailand would want to work with many other countries, especially around the region, in order to make sure that we can grow together, we can prosper together, and make sure that there will be equity in the society along the way. I think that should be enough for half of your dinner. So let me just finish the written speech, only half of them, by saying that when you met in 2014, November in Yangon, Myanmar, Ms. Ariwan, who was on stage a little bit earlier, has been elected as APT Secretary General, and she has pledged to carry out her duties in key four areas, and that is togetherness, efficiency, accountability, and mobilization. And I think this is a time to reflect the achievement that she has promised in 2014. What I can say is that what we have seen under her leadership, APT Secretariat as a whole has performed its duties remarkably. But without the support and contribution of you all as APT members, these successes could not have been reached. On behalf of the Royal Thai Government, I would like to take this opportunity to extend our deep appreciation to all APT members for your support to not only Ms. Ariwan, but also for the work of the APT as a whole. And as you have witnessed, Thailand has always been a devoted country in telecommunity since its foundation. Apart from the support on human resource to APT, we are very pleased and honored that APT members agreed to have APT headquarters in Bangkok. And like other members, we also support other activities of APT, including hosting many of the APT work programs. So with this strong commitment and intention, the government of Thailand has decided to nominate Ms. Ariwan for the post of APT Secretary General for the second term. And this will allow her and her team to continue to work with all stakeholders of APT, including regional coordination, information sharing, capacity building, and development projects. We do hope that APT members will support her again in this election. And to continue and strengthen the role of Thailand in telecommunication and ICT work, we also have decided to announce for the 10th consecutive term a re-election to ITU Council for Region E, and that is Asia and Australasia. The election for which will be held during the forthcoming ITU Plenipotentiary Conference in Dubai, United Arab Emirates, from 29th October to 16th of November 2018. So if re-elected to the Council, Thailand pledged to continue to work closely with ITU member states, particularly APT member states, ITU, and international community to leverage ICT and telecommunication for the benefit of the region and of the world. So last but not least, I hope this reception tonight will add some strength for you for more discussion in the next 2 days. I wish you all fruitful discussions, excellent outcome of the meeting, and hopefully you have enjoyable time in Bangkok or any other province. And please make sure you empty your purse. Spend all your money in Thailand. We need that for our Thai local economy. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir.